everyone, it's Suzanne here. Thanks for joining me for another Monday Makes video. Today's card, I will be using the Flurry of Wishes stamp set and the Woodland embossing folder. I'm just showing you that I am going to be stamping ink directly on the embossing folder, and I just want to make sure that that Sizzix name that's actually on the embossing folder, that it's face down, if that makes sense. And I just inked the embossing folder up, and I'm placing a little piece of Whisper White thin cardstock. I'll be putting that through the Big Shot, and then out comes an inked background plus an embossed background. Cool, hey? So I'm using Versamark ink pad, and I'm smooshing the Versamark all over the card front. And then I'm using my Heat and Stick powder. And this is like an embossing powder. It's just powdered glue, really. And it is quite awesome. All you have to do is heat it with your heat tool. And you don't want to heat it too much and dry it. You just want to heat it till it melts, and then it becomes like a super sticky glue, which will adhere glitter exceptionally well. So I'm using my Dazzling Diamonds, and I'm just sprinkling generously all over. This is the one technique that I did not have to use the embossing buddy. So no worries about that, because you want that Heat and Stick powder to stick everywhere and the glitter to stick everywhere. And then just a light heating on top of the glitter just to make sure everything sticks. I'm putting some Fast Fuse on the back of a little bit of Fun Foam to keep everything nice and straight. And then a little bit of Fast Fuse on the back of the Fun Foam. And I'm going to be adhering that to the white Whisper White thick card base, which I have down below. Just sort of kept that piece of paper there to collect all my glittery bits. And what I ended up doing was using my marker and coloring in the snowflake. And I used Soft Sky, Tempting Turquoise, and Marina Mist, along with some rhinestones. And I heat embossed the sentiment from the Flurry of Wishes set, and I'm just putting that on with dimensionals. And then I'm putting the snowflake. I hand cut that because I don't have the punch, but I liked it better anyway. It's more detailed. And that's the card. I have a couple more examples at the end of this video.